Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV, folks. My name is Will Warren. Our cameraman today is none other than Optimus Prime.
Optimus Prime today.
Right? Yes. Isn't that right? This is Tom.
Yeah, just the only Tom
just
that works
Tom.
Here.
Just Tom. That's it. He didn't even have a last name. He's just Tom.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
But today, we're going to be doing our video on the 212 high wall.
Yep.
And we're going to show you our cameraman, Octavio, for the first time today. And you'll find out why he's called Optimus Prime.
Optimus Prime. Well, I see you're in your natural position.
It's the throne, brother.
It's the throne.
That's the throne.
That's the squatty potty on this coach.
That is the squatty potty on this coach. All you really need is a rock in front of you.
Yeah, isn't there like a invention or something that they came out with?
Yeah. I think, with unicorns and stuff like that in the commercial.
Stuff.
Well, you guys, let's start talking about what you see here.
Yeah.
This is the A212 high wall.
Yeah.
It is a pop-up camper. Mm-hmm. However, you notice, of course, there's no canvas, right?
No canvas.
It's completely hard-sided coach.
Yep, absolutely. Now, the way that this is about a 21-foot coach, and this is really designed for people that don't want to deal with the canvas. It's an easy setup. This wall folds down along with the opposite wall, and then this is on a motorized roof, and then you can just lower this sucker down, and it just comes right on down on top of each other. You could probably do the whole thing in about, less than 30 seconds or so.
Yeah.
So it's really easy to set up and take down. This is designed for those SUVs, those Jeeps and stuff, people that have those weight restrictions that maybe can't tow a whole lot. This is a great setup, great coach for something like that.
Yeah, being low, when you collapse it down, it tows very easily in the wind. There's really nothing else. Tom kind of covered it all.
Yeah.
So let's get started on some of the features you're going to see.
Yes. You know, one of the things that we'll notice on this coach, Will, as we're going through talking about this, tons and tons of storage on here.
There are tons of storage.
You can put the kitchen sink and everything else in between in this coach. So let's talk about it.
Let's talk about that. I mean, right here, you have the first storage compartment we're going to show off to you. So this is directly underneath your bed area. Yeah, and if you can put the camera in there, you can see you got lots of storage.
You know what I'm going to do?
Don't mind the dust.
I'm actually going to raise this up so Octavio can kind of get in here.
Oh, yeah. Take a look now.
And we'll show the inside, but you know, right here, you can access it from the bed. My arm can come in here and grab anything that I need to in this area, too.
Yeah. Now, obviously, you can store tons of camping gear in there. You can also store your 2.5-gallon squatty potty. Now, this, of course, is exactly like it sounds. There's no bathroom built into this particular coach.
No.
So you can bring this out here, and you can enjoy the fresh air while you just take care of business. And it's 2.5 gallons. It's easily dumped into, you usually probably dump it at a dump station, but you could also dump it into your toilet if need to. And there is chemical that you put into something like this to make it sure that it doesn't get a little ripe on you while you're traveling down the road. So that usually will store right in here.
You know, a good shovel does the same thing.
It does.
You know, moving, oh, I'm sorry, Will.
Oh, I was gonna say moving down the line.
Moving down the line.
Were you gonna say moving along?
Well, moving along. So, of course, with all of our Rockwoods, Will, we're gonna get a prep station.
Yep.
And then you're also gonna get a grill that's gonna sit right here as well next to it. It's got a direct feed gas line into that grill for you. And actually, when the grills come, they're packed into this little cardboard box here. So usually we have one on display and we don't like to open these up because these are for the customers, but you'll have that. You can shoot everything on there as you want to, because that's where you want to be anyways when you're camping.
Yeah, you don't want to necessarily be cooking greasy bacon inside your coach. Come out here and do it.
Yeah.
Don't worry about the mess. This right here is just your power cord. It does come with a 30-amp power source, or power cord, I should say. We give you a little adapter though, so when you guys are camping and if you don't happen to have a 30-amp connection, you can still plug it into 20-amp or even a 110 outlet.
Yeah, and you'll want that because, so this coach is bonus. It's got a bonus because it does have an air conditioner built in.
It's true.
It's got an air conditioner with a heat pump, and it also has a separate heater inside as well that's going to work off of propane.
Oh, and you got the microwave too, of course.
And you got the microwave.
So yeah, you still have all those things that can run off that 30 amp power.
Yep. You got an outside speaker here. Of course, it's marine grade, so it can get wet. This is going to be your roof lift system. You have your 110 power out here outlet that you can plug into. Of course, this is your radio antenna.
Obviously, Tom is the one touching the radio antenna this time.
Yeah,
not me. since I busted it off last time.
You broke that one. So see, look, there's certain things you got to do to move this around. You just can't be yanking on a wheel. So, you know, 10-year axle warranty on the torsion flex suspension system. Mm-hmm. Folks, why is that important to you? Well, just like anything else that's good with the Rockwood, quality, right? So 10-year axle warranty, if anything goes wrong in those first 10 years that you own the camper, it's going to be covered by the manufacturer. So as we come down, you get a swing handle here. You can lock it into place either way. Two steps up into the coach, of course. And as we're kind of moving on down, you'll notice that you're also going to have some more storage. Now, we just got this one from the factory, so this one's still got the propane bottles in here, and then here's your cover for your battery. But you're also going to get a water filtration system that's on board, too. Now, this little filter will filter out up to 0.9 microns of the bad stuff. So no matter where you're getting your water from, no matter how you bring it along with you, you'll feel safe using it with this filter that's on here. And also, you have this huge storage bin. Now, Will, I bet you can fit in here.
I think Ox should try it.
Ox should try this? So this is kind of cool because you can slide out this storage container from either side of the coach. You can put a ton of things in here. Ox, why are you getting really close to me, man?
And this is, you can slide this out from either end as well.
Either end.
There's another hatch on the other side to open it up. And then right by Tom's head, this is another storage area. Another, so when Tom was saying there's storage, he's not lying. There's a ton of storage. You can put you can put whatever you want in here.
This is where your game goes.
We decided that, right?
This is where your killed game goes. Now, I learned this from a hunter, well, a customer of mine.
Tarp?
He says, Tom, put a tarp in here, throw some dry ice in there, you cut up your game, you throw it in here, and it's a great way to transport it home from your
hunting trip. Hunting that's trip. What you're looking for.
That's the word I'm looking for.
Yep.
Right.
Yep.
Yeah. So great little store. Of course, if you're not a hunter, you can put a bunch of other things in here, additional coolers, lawn chairs, whatever else you can think of in here. But that's just a tidbit.
Yeah.
So power tongue jack you'll get on here. You also have a docking light that's on here. Two 20-pound LP bottles. You have a battery back here as well. Now, the dry weight on this coach, because you want to make sure if you can pull this or not. So the dry weight, and when we talk about, there's two different weights, the dry weight and then the full GVWR after you're fully loaded with all of your gear on board. There's two weights, and really the one that you want to pay attention to is the GVWR. The dry weight, just as it sits, just as it's coming from the factory, is going to be 2433. And then the GVWR on here, that means fully loaded with all of your gear, is going to be $3,297. So you'll definitely want to check and see if your small SUV can tow it or not.
Now, also on the front here, I just want to point out too, you do have this other bright LED floodlight. So if you're loading up your game or whatever you want to put in the front here, you can see what you're doing out here. There's also the diamond plate, and that's a nice feature as well. Typically, if you get a rock strike from your vehicle, this is where it's going to happen. And so you're not going to end up breaking any fiberglass. Instead, it'll hit this metal and just bounce right off. Obviously, this right here is the other side of the storage compartment Tom was showing earlier.
Look at that. Either side.
So it's easily accessible. A lot of times, if you don't have this, you're crawling through. And try doing that with a hole this size.
Yeah. Well, I could probably do it.
Well, yeah, but you're probably the only one of us.
I'll probably get stuck in there. I probably would. And then, of course, you're going to have your 6-gallon direct spark ignition water heater right here.
And that recovers at a rate of 10.8 gallons per hour, I believe.
Your 30 amp cord will plug in here. So when you're plugged into a campsite and you want to work your AC and you want to work your microwave and all those 110 power outlets, you got to have direct power coming into the coach or a generator, of course.
And the other nice thing about this though is that when you plug into power, there's a little itty bitty light on the cap of this. So if that light doesn't turn on this cap right here, then you know that you're not getting power between your pedestal or wherever you're plugged in at to the coach. So there's something in between the coach and your power source that's not getting the power to you. Otherwise, this light will turn on green and it means you have power in the coach.
Yeah, here's your service panels for your refrigerator that's on board. You also have a hot and cold water feature. Now, this is something that I like to bring
water
up to
feature.
Any water feature. Well, it could be a water feature. You could just kind of trickle it. But what I like to recommend to people, and again, this is what I learned from one of my customers, you can put the little squatty potty right here, Will. And it's right, right in front of the tire. And then
and
you can
like
kind of, you
bidet?
Can kind of.
Oh, no, not a bidet.
sorry. That's, no, not a bidet.
You were going with
this
the squatty potty,
show,
man.
Will. Yeah, I was going with the squatty potty. So you can do actually all three or whatever right here. So not a bad little, and a lot, what a lot lot of people do too, folks, is they'll get an aftermarket awning that they'll put out here, like a little portable, you know, what do you call those things?
Shower stands?
No, not the shower stands, but awning. the little cover awning, but it's not screened in.
Screen room.
But you can get a screen room, put it on this side, and then this becomes your shower room.
That way area. You can bidet in private.
You and the bidet, man. You and mate. No wonder you guys are like best buddies. Anyway. So right here, you're gonna have your potable tank fill. Now this is basically your canteen that's on board, your fresh water. You got about 26 gallons in this coach that you can utilize. Or if you're gonna be plugged into a campsite that offers you full hookups, you can go ahead and put your hose right in here, of course with a water pressure reducing valve, and you'll get direct feed of water into your camper. Now if you want to hook up TV, cable, satellite, or whatever, you have this little area that you can plug into that as well.
And then right here, this is that lift that Tom was talking about earlier. So you don't have to lift the roof of this coach by hand anymore, which is good when you're shorter like me. Tom could probably do it, no problem.
Yeah.
But this is really handy. That means only these side panels are the ones you have to lift up by hand. Now this little black grate right here, a lot of people ask, well, what is this? Well, this is the exhaust for the AC. So that's where that is. And we were talking earlier about storage. There's even more storage. Now, Tom, I know you can't fit in there.
Will you give me a dollar if I try?
No, nope, nope. Yeah. I'll give you a dollar if you do it. And you make it.
And I make it.
Now on the back here, let me show you guys a couple of things. You have the nice skylight, and you'll get to see how much light that brings in when we get inside. Mm-hmm. And then of course you have your spare. What's really nice about the spare is that they give you this hard shell. A lot of times on coaches, you'll see that, you know, canvas cover they have for your extra spare tire. And what happens is it ends up over time looking like that dirt right there. It gets chapped and cracked and just it falls apart on you.
Gets
versus
brittle.
This is not gonna do that to you.
Yeah. You know, there's a lot of features on the outside of the coach, but there's also a ton on the inside too.
Let's
we should show the people
out.
The features on the inside.
Yeah. Hey guys, come on in. Let me show you some of the inside features on this 212. All right, now the first thing I want to mention is that skylight back here that we have seen on the outside. Let me show you what it's like on the inside. Large window. Now the only thing I'm not sure of is where Tom went, but I kind of hear something underneath the bed. Wow.
Well,
I guess I owe you that dollar.
You know, I just need to prove a theory that you can stick a 6'2", 200 pound man in this enclosure here. And
you can.
Successfully.
I mean,
that's how much storage is back up underneath the bed, man.
Sheila would be so proud. Well,
she probably, either that or she'd try to figure out we never work here. We just goof around all the time. But you know what? It's all about demonstrating for the people, and I'm willing to take one for the team.
Okay, now here we are at the front of the inside of the coach, and obviously I'm sitting at the dinette. Now you have two windows, obviously with shades, a nice LED light above as well to give you lots of light. Now this can be transformed into another bed. Same size as what's across that Tom is sitting on right now.
I'm relaxing.
You are relaxing.
That was a
buddy.
Lot of work getting up underneath there, by the way.
I can tell.
So I'm a little exhausted.
Good thing you're doing all your yoga, right?
Yeah.
Stretching out.
Yeah, exactly.
So, now there is some other features up here I want to point out to you. Down underneath this cushion here is a storage area. And right now that's where we have like the propane tank, the battery box, things like that. But you can, once this coach is all set up, you can use that for whatever storage you want. Down here, Tom was talking about the heater on this coach, and that's located right here. So this is your propane furnace. So you can use your propane tanks to heat this coach, and this will heat very quickly. Also, if you don't want to use your propane, you can always use the AC heat pump that Tom is sitting
right
above.
Which is right here, as a matter of fact. And this thing will get cold enough. It'll freeze you out of here along with the heat. That'll cook you out of here too. Plenty great systems to be in this coach.
Right.
I mean, they work very efficiently.
Now, right beside this heater, you have a GFI outlet, so you can always use this to power whatever you bring along with you. And then this little box right here is your fuse and breaker box, and it'll also, it's your converter box too, so that's what ends up charging your batteries when you're plugged in. Let me show you this next. So this right here is your refrigerator. Now this is not like your normal at-home fridge. This will power itself off of three different modes. So it'll power and cool off of your battery. So that's really great when you're getting to your destination to keep your fridge nice and cold. It'll work off of propane. That's great when you get to your destination. If you don't happen to have an electrical hookup, you can use propane to cool the fridge, or it'll power itself off of a regular shore connection. So generator or shore power. So if you have a campsite with power, great, plug in and this will cool off that. If you happen to be at home and you're trying to cool it down beforehand, just plug it in that way. You open it up by pulling on this little release tab here, and you can see you got plenty of door space here, three shelves, and then also you got your freezer area too. So you can bring along popsicles for the kids or whatever the case is.
You know, Will, that's a lot of explanation. Really, the people just want to know, will it keep their beer cold?
Yes. Yes, we'll keep your beer cold.
That's all they want to know, man.
And for the beer that you are going to be cooling down later, the beer that you have to store warm, they give you this little hanging wardrobe. So obviously you probably use it for clothes, or you could use it for more alcohol.
Yeah, it'll clip right here. These little four clips, it'll go right here. And then of course you have this little hanging bar right here that you can put all your clothes that are on a hanger. You don't want those to get wrinkled, you put them right there. And you can keep those out of your way.
You can obviously see the counter space in the kitchen too. I just took off these two items here. This just has papers up for the coach and things like that. But you got a lot of prep space for a small
coach. You got a lot of prep space. Now, one of the things that we need to point out, especially when you take this guy down, and I'm just going to take it off, is because when you collapse and you fold up this roof, this sidewall is going to come down. You want to make sure that you take this off and put it in the sink so that you're not breaking anything. But your sink here is going to have hot and cold water options on here. Here you're going to have a microwave. Now you do need to be plugged into 110 power to operate that. You're going to have a gas stove and oven. And then this little guy just folds up here, and you got a three burner stove right here. And then this will act as your backsplash, so you're not getting all the grease and everything else on your drapery and on the vinyl sidewalls here. So you got a lot of cool things going on. Lots of drawers up underneath. Again, we talked about storage and I demonstrated, you know, against my better judgment. But you got tons of storage in here for pots and pans and everything you can think of. Another 110 power outlet here. But one of the things I want to mention too is that this bed also, it's a heated mattress. So you get a little plug that plugs in right here with a little dial 1 through 6, and you plug it in right here. Now you do have to be plugged in to electricity to operate this feature, but it's a nice little touch on this particular coach. It really sets it apart. When it's cold outside, you just cuddle up right here, turn this little guy on, and stay warm.
Yeah, there are a couple things I forgot to mention. One of which is actually right above us. Blah, there we are.
Max Air Fan.
The Max Air Fan. Right now we have that going.
We do, it's hot in here. Well, it was until we turned it on.
So what we do is we often will open up the windows and flip on that fan. It's just like a whole house fan for the coach. So cycles the air out. It technically, at the highest setting, it moves 920 cubic feet of air per minute. So that's a lot of air flow through this coach. If you're in the mountains, that's probably all you're gonna need. You won't even need to bother with the AC. Also, the coach does come equipped with a stereo, and you get a little remote for it. It's right down there by the door, and that'll play CDs and also do radio. And then your Dometic AC control and heat control is also right beside that as well, along with a fire extinguisher. And this light right here flips on a little tow light down here. That way, when Tom has to get up to use the bathroom at night, he's not going to stub his poor little footsies.
Hey, you'll be there one of these days.
One of these days, yeah.
I'm the old man around here.
And, one last thing I forgot to mention, but we're not going to forget it this time, is there's a mirror right here. Okay, come on. All right. There's Octavio. That's the man. You can see why we call him Optimus Prime.
Optimus Prime.
So.
Optimus Prime, yeah. I used to call him Steven Seagal Jr. because he had the little thing.
Oh, that's right.
Now he cut his hair really short. Now I just call him Dirty Q-Tip.
Well, thank you guys for watching this inside video on the 212.
Yeah, but you know what we should do, Will?
What?
We should collapse this thing and show the people.
Give the people what they want.
Let's give them what they want.
All right, so now we're going to show you guys how to collapse this unit really quick. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off the fan. I'm going to make sure it gets closed. So there's three settings on it to determine the speed you want to go with. And then You have to lower it down with this guy right here, just twist that knob, and then there's a lock on it as well. So that way it doesn't fly open on you when you're driving down the road. So that's locked in place now. And like Tom said, you need to make sure that this is out of the way, because when this whole wall drops down, you're gonna crush this or possibly break your window. So anyways, we'll pop that off. You unlatch the latch back here, which we've already done, and then you come up to this side, unlatch that, and you literally just pull forward. And this drops down. And this one here has to drop first, because the next one is designed to go on top of it, which Tom will show you.
Yes, I will demonstrate. So what you're gonna wanna do is you wanna come in here, you wanna close this door completely. And then before I do that, there's this little hinge that you have to undo. So I'm gonna close this guy. I'm gonna undo the hinge. And the reason that you're gonna need to do this is because when you lower this wall down, well, you have to have a place for your head to go. So it's gonna kinda stick out a little bit. So I'm gonna open up these latches here. And then what I'm gonna do, and this one's already latched because you're gonna wanna do this one, because when this one's down, then it'll be kinda tough to get over there. So unlatch that one. And then what you're gonna do is you're just gonna bring this guy down. And you're gonna lower it on top of the other one. Now you notice that this door is here still. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna step out. You're just gonna close this, and then this door just shuts just like this. And then, shoot, the hard work is over. So now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna come over here and unlock, get the main roof part of itself, and then we're gonna hit the down button.
So obviously, yeah, this down is for retract, up is for extend.
We should record to see how long this was gonna take us.
Well, you know, it really doesn't take...
It doesn't take long
all that long.
Nope.
I felt like when they first came out, maybe they had a smaller motor on it, and it took... I remember that taking a long time.
But it's easy to do. Nonetheless, it's super easy to pop up.
Oh, you know what? I want to show you guys something really quick here. Okay, so I'm going to pop this up a little bit more. Okay? And in just a sec, you're going to see those lights kick on, just like that. So, if you accidentally leave your LED lights on, once you reach a certain point, it cuts the power to them. That way you're not draining your battery while this thing is all closed up.
And that's all there is to it.
There's
a clasp on this side, there's a clasp on that side. You put all your stuff away and down the road you go. You know what, Will, I was a little nervous doing this film.
Because of me?
Well, because we have this new camera system. It's a little intimidating.
Well, yeah, when you have Optimus Prime like shoving metallic arm in your face.
I mean, you go from one regular camera to this thing with mechanical arms and a shoulder thing, and it just looks weird.
It looks like a cyborg.
It does look like a cyborg. Anyway, folks, thanks for joining us on the Rockwood 212 High Wall video journey.
Yes.
You can always reach out to myself don't bother Will. He's very rarely here. No, I'm just teasing. But anyway, I'm one of the sales guys. He's my sales manager. Come on down and see me. You can reach me at 970-313-4337, or you can reach out to me on my email at tom@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Of course, Will's always available.
Yeah, if you want to talk to the guy who's never here, you can always email me directly at will@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. And actually, we have the same phone number. It's 970-313-4337. It just comes to all of us. Ask for Tom, ask for me, ask for Ock, and tell him he looks great in the video.
Yeah, with give him a thumbs up if you like Ock.
His like octopus metal arms or whatever's going on.
Right.
And if you guys really enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to our channel, because we pump out new content all the time, and hit that bell button. That way you'll know when we got a new video. Also, feel free to leave a comment. Let us know what you thought.
Yeah, always live, always unscripted, boys and girls.
That's true.
We don't read off a teleprompter or anything. So whatever we say, that's how we talk.
That's Ock's next attachment. It's gonna go right over his head.
Are you kidding me? Oh my God, I'm gonna have to retire.
I don't know how he's gonna fit through the doors.
I'm gonna have to retire. Just gonna have to do it.
Thank you guys for watching.
Take care.